Well, it won't let me leave. It won't let me leave. Something lacking.
Thank you.
Teach without you. Lord, I need you, God.
Just before us.
Yes, Lord. Yes. I stand on your promises. I have faith in you. I trust in you. I believe in you. Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. They know not what they say. Show them who they are in you, in truth. Lord, show everybody where they belong, God. Gather your people, God. Gather them in unity and not under man, one person. Oh God, we should do what the Spirit saith. We should do what Revelation saith. Follow him whithersoever he is. The Spirit of the mighty God. He's over there. Go over there. He's here. I'll stay here. Wherever the Spirit is, and moving, wait and tarry. We need to be on one accord. It's biblical. And the grudging, and the strife, and the division, God, I ask you to cast it all out. Simply trying to do what you ask me to do. But I'll take a step back to do my duties as the pastor here. Everybody else can have you too. But right now, I have to focus on my family. And this, Lord, these are my two support a nation from you. I don't have the strength unless you anoint me to do anything else. So, the Lord's laid on my heart. People talk about judge, don't judge. It's actually unbiblical. You got to know who you're talking to first and foremost. And what the thing is we're judging. Are we judging unrighteously? Are we judging righteously? Are we judging what we want to eat? You got to be careful what you eat. Healthy eat. Eating healthy, and that goes with spiritual food as well. You don't want to eat something that's bad for you to digest into your spirit. There's actually a book of Judges. If you didn't know, it's in the Old Testament. It's a book of Judges, and let's go to Judges 4:4. It says, "And Deborah, a prophetess, the wife of Lapidoth, she judged Israel at that time." So God raised up judges, and people always say that when certain people speak or when certain people teach or preach, they feel a conviction or condemnation, like they're being judged. It's actually biblical. It's not that the person saying, you know, "I deem you hell worthy." It's simply the Holy Ghost moving. And if that person is a judge, then that will be what that is. It could be a prophetess preaching. Or teaching. And so judges are simply counsel. They're simply prophets. It's people that God raised up to show holiness and righteousness. That will be their main focal point, to preach holiness, righteousness, and repentance. And they're not going to sway one way, one iota, the way people would. They're not going to do that. Normal people will say one thing out this side of their mouth and go do another. But directly from God will be judgments on lands such as California, USA, world. Repent. Bear with me. Ruth 1:1. "Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled." Okay, 1 Samuel. Samuel was a prophet. "If one man sin against another, the judge shall judge him." That's in the book of Samuel the prophet. 1 Samuel 7:15, "And Samuel judged Israel all the days of his life." So, and in the New Testament it says a prophet named Agabus came down, and then another prophet called the people in the congregation slow belly. So he was judging them based on their learning skills and abilities. And so, you know, just bear with me. "Judge not, lest you be judged. By the same measure you judge, it shall meet." You know, that's the scripture everybody quotes. But the Bible says to rightly divide all truths. Vitally divine. That's one scripture. You got 27 others that tell you you should judge and you can judge, and God will judge us, absolutely. And there's only one that can judge us with the final judgment, and either life or second death, which is hell. 2 Chronicles 19:5, and he set judges in the land throughout all the fenced cities of Judah, by city by city. Ezra 7:25, thou, Ezra, after the wisdom of thy God that is in thine hand, set magistrates and judges, which may judge all the people that are beyond the river. See, this is council. This is the council of God. This is the government of God. We're talking about God himself and the Spirit of God in people. Job 9:15, whom thou, I were righteous, yet I would not answer, but I would make supplication to my judge, the master judge, the judge. Job 12:17, he leadeth counselors away spoiled and maketh the judges fools. Basically, a lot of times that's what nowadays judges are. I'm not talking about prophets. Well, some people that call themselves prophets act foolish, but I'm talking about the court system judges. Psalms 7:11. God judges the righteous, and God is angry with the wicked every day. Psalm 9:19, arise, O Lord, let no man prevail, let the heathen be judged in thy sight. Psalm 35:24, judge me, O Lord, my God, according to thy righteousness, and let them not rejoice over me. Isaiah 1:17, learn to do well, seek judgment. That's well, seeking judgment. Relieve the oppressed, judge the fatherless, plead for the widow. There's a lot of fatherless society nowadays, and they are oppressed, and there's some widows as well, and it's a bad situation with a torn family. It's hard, it's difficult on the family. Isaiah 33:22, for the Lord is our judge, the Lord is our lawgiver, the Lord is our king, he will save us. Thank you, Jesus. Jeremiah, who was another prophet. Isaiah was another prophet or judge. Jeremiah 11:20, but O Lord of hosts, that judgest righteously, that trieth the reins of the heart, let me see thy vengeance on them. For unto thee have I revealed my cause. Mercy, Lord. Lamentation 3:59, O Lord, thou hast seen my wrong, judge thou my cause. Ezekiel, who was another prophet, 7:3. Now is the end come upon thee, and I will send my anger upon thee, and I will judge thee according to thy ways, and will recompense upon thee all thine abominations. Now that's the word of the Lord, but the prophet was speaking it. You got to understand that. He was judging the land. He was warning them through the Lord. Daniel, another prophet, he spoke of judgment. Judgment of king when the hand was writing on the wall, he interpreted it. Hosea was another prophet, and or judge, they are all hot as an oven and have devoured their judges. Talks about killing prophets. They can't stand to hear whatever people do. They don't want to hear that they do it. It's strange, but anyway, that's facts. If you try to tell them they're doing it wrong and that's not biblical or not holy or righteous, they'll want to say things, do things. And Joel, another prophet, let the heathen be awakened and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat, for there I will set to judge all the heathen round about. It's not good to be a heathen. It's not good to be a sinner. If you're a heathen, you're going to get the most judgment out of all. Amos was another prophet. He was made a prophet. And I will cut off the judge from the midst thereof, and I will slay all the princes thereof with him, saith the Lord. Lord, take not your spirit from me. Obadiah and Micah, it's in there too. Zephaniah. It says that the judges were wolves. They gnaw the bones. Zechariah. And then it goes to Matthew. And then it goes into Matthew 7. Judge not that you be not judged, and that's everybody's favorite. And then you go to Luke, and then it says the same thing. Judge not, and you shall not be judged. Condemn not, and you shall not be condemned. All right. John 7:24, judge not according to the appearance, but judge righteous judgment. The Bible says that the eyes are the window to the soul, and God can look at the heart of a man. It's a big discrepancy today about judging people. People can't judge people, but God certainly can speak through somebody and tell somebody to correct themselves. It says it in Acts, it says it in John. 1 John. Bear with me now. Bear with me. Romans 2:16. In the day when God shall judge the secrets of men by Jesus Christ according to my gospel. Romans 3:4, God forbid, yea, let God be true, but every man a liar, as it is written, that thou mightest be justified in thy sayings, and mightest overcome when thou art judged. Whew. Romans 3:6, God forbid, for then how shall God judge the world? A scripture that talks about us judging angels as well. have righteous judgment. This is one of my favorite scriptures, 1 Corinthians 2:15. But he that is spiritual judges all things, yet he himself is judged by no man. He that is spiritual judges all, but he is judged by no man. First Corinthians 6:3, know ye not that we shall judge angels, how much more things that pertaineth to life? Next verse, if then ye have judgments of things pertaining to this life, set them to judge who are less esteemed in the church. Set them to judge who are less esteemed in the church. Remember, apostles come before prophets, and apostles can judge and prophesy as well. And their watchmen as well, but the prophet is the teacher, the teaching, and the apostle does the evangelizing and the preaching, and oftentimes teaching too. This is biblical now. I'm teaching your Bible. Don't get mad with me. I'm telling you the truth. First Corinthians 11:31, for if we would judge ourselves, we would not be judged. In other words, look in the mirror, cast a beam out of your own eye. 1 Corinthians 14:29, let the prophet speak two or three, and let the other judge. See, the prophet that interprets or prophesies after speaking in tongues, the other prophet is judging, and they'll either say yeah and leave it alone, or they'll speak too. Judges of evil thoughts. Judgment must first start at the house of God. I didn't see that one. I don't know where it's at. It's got to be in here. Oh, I saved it. Let's see. I must have skipped over it. I was right there. Just a minute. I got one more that's on my heart. There's just so many. Talks about judgments and judging. And see if I can find it. It'll be quicker to look it up on here. I'll just read it from here. It's 1 Peter 4:17. I know it was the book of Peter. I can't remember exactly where it was. That's got to be in here. I thought that I saved it. Let me try to look and see if I can find it one more time. Doesn't matter, but I want to get this teaching together. Yeah, there it is. Is it? No, it's not in here. I got 1 Peter 1:17. Anyway, 1 Peter 4:17, and that one says, "And if ye call on Father, who without respect of persons judgeth according to every man's work, past the time of your sojourning here in fear." That's 1 Peter 1:17. Now let's go to 1 Peter 4:17. "For the time is come," talking about now, the last days, "that judgment must begin at the house of God." The built house of God. "And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God?" Obey not the gospel out of Christ, out of the church, out of the buildings. And so, that's that. Uncertain. Uncertain why, but I obeyed. Amen. God bless you. In Jesus' name.